from Matthew 5, verses 13 through 16. Jesus said to his disciples, "You are the salt of the earth, but if salt loses its taste, with what can it be seasoned? It is no longer good for anything but to be thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city set on a mountain cannot be hidden, nor do they light a lamp and then put it under a bushel basket. It is set on a lampstand, where it gives light to all in the house. Just so, your light must shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your heavenly Father."
Connor and Daisy, today is the culmination of an incredible 5.5 year relationship. You guys have been through so much together in those 5.5 years. You think about the stresses of college, you know, the exhaustion of overnight gaming sessions.
You look beautiful.
Thank you. You look so handsome.
I love you so much.
I love you too.
Oh man, I'm probably not allowed to kiss you.
Romans 12, 1 through 2, 9 through 13. "I urge you, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God, your spiritual worship. Do not conform yourselves to this age, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you will discern what is the will of God, what is good and pleasing and perfect. Let love be sincere. Hate what is evil. Hold on to what is good. Love one another with mutual affection. Anticipate one another in showing honor. Do not grow slack in zeal. Be fervent in spirit. Serve the Lord. Rejoice in hope. Endure in affliction. Persevere in prayer."
Like Connor and Daisy, both of these readings here today call for your marriage to be set apart from any other marriage that's out there. In Matthew, we hear that your marriage should be a light to the world. That world can be dark sometimes. You know, you had this couple together, getting married, and everything was going great. They had their friends, they had their family, great music, good food, but they ran out of wine. And Jesus turned water into wine and really saved their wedding. But that miracle only happened because Jesus was there to perform it. There's going to be times in your life, in your marriage, that you run out of wine. But if you invite Jesus in, he'll be there to perform those miracles when they're needed. Okay, so you might ask yourself, how do I bring Christ into my marriage? And it isn't as simple as both being good Christians. It's just this intentional effort to be Christians together as one.
Thoughts of you have been on my mind ever since that day in February when you and I met. I can still picture you screaming up to me from the Joffrey parking lot, inviting me down to your dorm room to eat Papa John's pepperoni pizza. I can still picture taking you to the bowling alley for our first date, and you kicking my ass even though you swore that you were bad. I can still picture it all, the hall meetings, the hall events, but especially that night when I stayed in your dorm room until 3 a.m. just a few short weeks after we had begun dating. That was the night that I knew I was in love with you, Daisy.
I never let it go, and I promise to support and lift you up in every way that I can. And although I'm not perfect and cannot always promise to be the most patient and the most kind, I promise to learn from all of our conversations and compromises to build the strongest foundation for our marriage and for our lives. I promise to build a home and a life with you that we can, of course, be proud of.
Connor, repeat after me as you place the ring on her left hand. I, Connor, give you, Daisy, this ring.
I, Connor, give you, Daisy, this ring.
as a symbol of my love and devotion.
As a symbol of my love and devotion.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I promise to honor you.
I promise to honor you.
And cherish you.
And cherish you.
In God's name.
In God's name.
This is a lot less complicated.
I, Daisy, give you Connor this ring.
As a symbol of my love and devotion.
As a symbol of my love and devotion.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I promise to honor you.
I promise to honor you.
And cherish you.
Cherish you.
In God's name.
In God's name.
Now that Connor and Daisy have exchanged vows and exchanged rings, I ask you all to bow your heads and join me in a prayer for them. Heavenly Father, we thank you that Daisy and Connor have found themselves a partner for life. We ask for your grace and blessing in their marriage. Help them to love each other forever. Grant them all their heart's desires. Let their house be filled with laughter always. Let them put you at the center of their marriage. Be their comforter, their mediator, and provider. Grant them the fruits of the womb. Give them happiness with no limits. Open the floodgates of blessings on their marriage. Let them settle any issues that arise themselves, and let their marriage be a shining example for others.
As you know, my grandfather, your great-grandfather, was Scottish, and in a traditional Scottish wedding, the father of the bride will give a wedding blessing and a toast. So I'd like to take a second out to do an old Gaelic one translated, mind you, for you both right now. So Daisy and Connor, wherever in the world you both ship, oh, I already screwed it up, how about that? Wherever you live in the world so wide, we wish you a nook on the sunny side. With much love and little care, a little purse with money to spare, in your own little hearth when the day is spent, in your own little home with heart's content. So, let us toast the health of the bride, and let us toast the health of the groom. Let us toast he that tied, where'd he go? And every person in this room. Sláinte, cheers.
I'd ask you to all stand. And it is my great pleasure to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Connor and Daisy Simmons.
Yes, it is.
Am I allowed to wipe it off?
Fine, you may.
Thank you.
Every last piece of me.